Good morning. Today I will talk about the genital system, male and female genital system. And the objectives of this presentation are an overview of the genital system, the male genital system, and the female genital system. Okay, we'll start by an overview of the genital system. This is the male genital system, and this is the female genital system. Each system is formed of primary sex organ, and the primary sex organ in the male is the testis, and the primary sex organ in the female is the ovary. Then secondary sex organs or genital ducts in the male, epididymis, vas deferens, seminal vesicle, ejaculatory duct, prostate gland, bulbourethral glands, and the urethra. In the female, uterine tube, uterus, and vagina. And the external genital organs. In the male, it is the penis. And in the female, it is the vulva. We'll start by the male genital system. Again, it's formed of three major parts. Primary sex organ, which is the testis. Secondary sex organs, or genital ducts. And external genital organ, which is the penis. The secondary sex organs or genital ducts and glands are. This is the first one, epididymis. Then the vas deferens, seminal vesicle, ejaculatory duct, prostate gland, bulbourethral glands, and the urethra. Okay. Regarding the testis, of course, men have two, one right and one left. The testis is located in a sac. It's called the scrotum. And the testis is located outside the abdomen for temperature regulation, because spermatogenesis takes place at a temperature of 33 to 34. Okay? Then the functions of the testis. Of course, it has two main functions. Number one, production of sperms by spermatogonia. Number two, production of the male sex hormone, testosterone, by cells called Leydig cells. And the testosterone is responsible for the male sex character or the external sex characters of the male. Okay? So the testis has two types of cells. Spermatogonia, for the formation of sperms, and the Leydig cells for formation of testosterone. It has another cells, another type of cells called Sertoli cells, but we'll talk about them later on in another lecture. This is a cross section of the testis. To know the structure of the testis, it is surrounded by a fibrous capsule, this one. This fibrous capsule is called the tunica albuginea. From the tunica albuginea, septa arise to divide the testis into lobules. So the testis is divided into 250 lobules by septa. Each lobule contains two seminiferous tubules. One, two. The seminiferous tubules fuse together at the mediastinum testis to form rete testis. This structure. And the rete testis is connected with the epididymis by vasa efferentia. And the testis is surrounded by a sac, serous sac, called the tunica vaginalis. This tunica vaginalis has parietal layer, visceral layer, and a cavity. Again, this is a close-up view of the structure of the testis, surrounded by fibrous capsule, tunica albuginea, divided into lobules by septa. Each lobule contains the two seminiferous tubules, 1, 2. The seminiferous tubules fuse to form rete testis. And the rete testis is connected with the epididymis by vasa efferentia. And the testis is surrounded by a sac called serous sac. It's called the tunica vaginalis. This tunica vaginalis has parietal layer, visceral layer, and a cavity. And this is a family photo. Okay, nice family. Now the epididymis. This is the epididymis. You should know the location, the parts, and the functions. The epididymis is located along the posterior border of the testis. So it is located behind the testis. This is the anterior border, this is the posterior border. It is divided into three parts. The upper part is called the head. The middle part is called the body. And the lower part is called the tail. And the tail is continuous with the vas deferens. What are the functions of the epididymis? We know that the sperms are formed in the testis and are stored in the epididymis. So storage of the sperms, so formation in the testis, storage in the epididymis. Number two, it is the site of maturation of the sperms. This means that sperms in the testis are immature and they are getting mature in the epididymis. And the third function, secretion of seminal fluid. Then the vas deferens. What is the length of the vas deferens? It is 45 centimeters. It is similar to the length of the spinal cord. It is similar to the length of the femur bone. Where does it begin and where does it end? So the beginning at the tail of the epididymis and the termination, okay, it ends by uniting with the duct of the seminal vesicle to form the ejaculatory duct. This is the ejaculatory duct. Then the seminal vesicles, this is the seminal vesicle, this is other seminal vesicle. Where is it? So it is located behind the urinary bladder. The duct of the seminal vesicle fuses with the vas deferens to form ejaculatory duct. So it unites with the vas deferens to form ejaculatory duct. Now, what are the functions of the seminal vesicle? Secretion of seminal fluid and the secretion of prostaglandins. The seminal vesicle doesn't store sperms. The sperms are stored in the epididymis. Then the ejaculatory duct, this very short duct. Okay, formation and determination. Formation, fusion of the vas deferens and the seminal vesicle. Termination, it opens in the prostatic part of the urethra. Now the prostate gland. Where is the prostate gland? it lies below the urinary bladder. This is the urinary bladder. This is the rectum. This is the anal canal. So position. Position below the urinary bladder. And then what are the functions of the prostate gland? The prostate gland secretes a fluid, which is added to the seminal fluid. So secretion of seminal fluid. And number two, it was thought that the prostate gland secretes prostaglandin, but now it is the seminal vesicle which secretes prostaglandins. So we can say that the prostate gland may secrete prostaglandins. But the main source of prostaglandins is the seminal vesicle, beside other glands in the body, like the submandibular salivary gland. Now we talk about the seminal fluid. What is the seminal fluid? The seminal fluid is the fluid containing the sperms. So actually the sperms are swimming in the seminal fluid. What is the amount of the seminal fluid? 3 to 4 milliliters in the normal ejaculate. What are the sources of the seminal fluid? We have main source and accessory sources. The main source, where the sperms are formed and stored. So the main source of seminal fluid is the testis and the epididymis. Accessory sources, seminal vesicles, prostate gland, and bulbourethral glands. Okay, what is the sperm content? 100 million sperms per milliliters. So if the normal ejaculate is 3 to 5 milliliters, then in the normal ejaculate, there are 300 to 500 millions of sperms. What are the functions of the seminal fluid? Seminal fluid contains fructose. So the first function is nutrition. It contains fructose for nutrition of the sperms. Number two, and it is very important, the pH of the seminal fluid is alkaline. Why alkaline? To neutralize the acidity of the vaginal secretions, or the acidity of the vagina. That's why acidic medium kills the sperms. And number three, do you remember the function of the seminal fluid, of the seminal vesicle? It secretes prostaglandins. So the seminal fluid contains prostaglandins. What is the function of the prostaglandins? Facilitate transport of the sperms in the female genital tract. So seminal fluid, it is 3 to 5 milliliters. The main source is the testis and the epididymis. The accessory sources are seminal vesicle, prostate, and the bulbourethral glands. The sperm content, 100 million sperms per milliliter. And the functions, number one, nutrition, because it contains the fructose. Number two, neutralizes the acidity of the vagina because it is alkaline. Number three, facilitates transport of the sperms because it contains prostaglandins. And finally, the male external genital organ, and the male external genital organ is called the penis. And the penis is formed of three parts. The first part is the root of the penis. This is the root of the penis. Second part is the body. And the third part is the glands. The root of the penis, this one, consists of two structures. The middle part is called the bulb. And this bulb is continuous with what is called corpus spongiosum, which contains the urethra. And the second part, the pink one, crura, or two crura, okay? And each crus is continuous with corpus cavernosum, erectile tissue. Now, the female genital organs or the female genital system. Again, the three main components: primary sex organ, which is the ovary; secondary sex organs, the genital ducts, which are uterine tube. This is a uterine tube. This is a uterus. And the vagina. So the three main parts, okay, the three structures: primary sex organs, the ovary; secondary sex organs or genital ducts, uterine tube, uterus, and the vagina. And the external genital organ is the vulva. This is the vulva. Okay? This is the ovary. Two ovaries. And the ovaries are present in the pelvis. And the functions of the ovary. Two main functions. Number one, production of the ova by oogonia. Number two, production of hormones, female sex hormones. And the female sex hormones are two: estrogen and progesterone. Estrogen makes the female look like and speak like female, so it is responsible for the external sex characters of the female. Progesterone is important for maintaining pregnancy. Now the uterus. This is the uterus. Where is the uterus? The position. Behind the urinary bladder and in front of the rectum. So between the urinary bladder anteriorly and the rectum posteriorly. Then the parts of the uterus. Three parts. This is the fundus. This is the body. And this is the cervix. And the cervix projects into the vagina. Okay? Then we'll talk about the wall of the uterus, or the three layers of the wall of the uterus. Okay, again, the three parts of the uterus: fundus, body, and the cervix. This is the fundus, this is the body, and this is the cervix. The body is 2 inches long, the cervix is 1 inch long, and the cervix has cervical canal, and this cervical canal opens into the uterine cavity by internal os, and opens into the vagina by external os. Then the three layers of the uterus, or the three layers of the wall of the uterus. The outer layer, this is the outer layer. It's called the perimetrium. The middle layer is a muscle layer. It's called the myometrium. And the inner layer, or actually the functional layer of the uterus, is the endometrium. So we have three layers. Perimetrium, the outer layer; myometrium, the middle layer; and the endometrium, the inner layer. Now the uterine tube. Talk about the lens, the parts, and the functions. The uterine tube is about 10 centimeters long. It is divided into four parts. This part is inside the wall of the uterus. So intramural, inside the muscle, inside the wall. This part is the narrowest part, isthmus. This part is the dilated part, ampulla of the uterine tube, or the lateral third. And this part divides into finger-like processes called fimbria and fundibulum. So intramural, isthmus, ampulla, and infundibulum. And the ampulla is the site of fertilization of the ovum. Okay? What are the functions of the uterine tube? It has two functions. Number one, transport of the sperms to the fertilization site in the lateral end of the uterine tube. Number two, after the formation of the zygote, transport of the zygote from the fertilization site to the cavity of the uterus. Then the vagina, or the birth canal. What is the length of the vagina? It is 3 to 4 inches. Look at the vagina. Look at the anterior wall and look at the posterior wall. The anterior wall is shorter than the posterior wall. So the anterior wall measures 3 inches. The posterior wall measures 4 inches. Position of the vagina. It is located between urinary bladder and urethra anteriorly, and rectum and the anal canal posteriorly. Direction of the anus of the vagina, it is directed downward and forward, and it opens in the vestibule of the vulva. And finally, the female external genital organ is called the vulva. This is the vulva. Okay, this is the vulva. It consists of clitoris. This is the clitoris. It is formed of two crura, this one and this one, crura. Number two, this structure, bulb of vestibule, which corresponds to the bulb of the penis. Okay, so clitoris, bulb of vestibule, and then two skin folds. The two skin folds, this is number one, the small one, and this is number two, the large one. So labia minora, or labia minus, and labia majora, or labia majus. So two skin folds, labia minora, this one and this one, the other one, and labia majus, labia majora. The space between the labia minora, this space, it's called the vestibule. So what is the vestibule of the vulva? The vestibule is the space between the labia minora. This vestibule contains two orifices. The posterior one is the vagina, and the anterior one is the urethra. Okay? So anterior one is the urethra, this one, and the posterior one is the vagina, and the vagina is closed by the hymen. Okay, again, summary. Primary sex organ. In the male, it is the testis. In the female, it is the ovary. Secondary sex organs. In the male, epididymis, vas deferens, seminal vesicle, ejaculatory duct, prostate gland, bulbo, urethral glands, urethra. In the female, uterine tubes, right and left, uterus and the vagina, and then the external genital organs. In the male, it is the penis. In the female, it is the vulva. Thank you very much. Good luck and best wishes.